All right, new bike day. Old bike, new bike to me. Something I've never owned, something I thought I would never own. A cyclocross gravel bike. Going for my first ride, it's completely stock. The gears are not for climbing, and I'm about to go up. So here we go. I'm gonna show you what I have and the suffering I'm about to go through.
Ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen.
So here it is. This is a 2016 Trek Crocket cyclocross bike. This is the aluminum version of what the pros use. The pros use the carbon version, which is called the Boon. Same geometry, different material. So I'm gonna go over real simple. FSA Energy hollow forge cranks with a 4632. And then I have an 1128 out the back. Yes, that is not for climbing. Or if it is, it's for guys with way stronger legs than me. We got 11 speed 105 in the rear. You can see some chain rub there. Some scratches. Whoever had this bike before me definitely rode it hard and raced. So tires are the CX3 Bontragers 700 by 32. 17 millimeter wide rims. Let me tell you, coming from a 3.0 tire, 29 by 3.0 with 50 mil rims, this is going to be really hard. Carbon fork, aluminum frame. Old school Avid BB7 brakes with 160 mil rotors, 105 shifters, and just Bontrager race bar, race stem, Bontrager paradigm, race gel, saddle. The thing that's really screwing me up in finding new wheels is the rear is a quick release 9mm, 135 spacing, and the front is a freaking 12mm by 100. So what that does for me is I have to find a rear wheel that has quick release or the 12 mil with an adapter that still can go to spacing for 135, from 142 to 135. So it's turning out to be more of a pain. I contacted some guys just in Georgia and they could build me a set of Novatex, $600. So I was like, hold on. A little much for this bike. I didn't pay that much for the bike. So here we go. I'm gonna take you on my first ever gravel ride. I haven't been on a road bike in years from my triathlon racing days. So I haven't even ridden my old mountain bike that I just sold, probably about 4 months. So here we go. We're in Franklin, North Carolina in the mountains. The trees are changing and it's gonna be a beautiful ride. All right, here we go. We're just gonna start this out. I am not in the proper gear. Come on. There we go. It's just straight up already. I have a feeling I'm not gonna make it all the way up, but we'll see. There's a fire. There's a firehouse up top or a fire lookout that we're definitely gonna try to make. But legs are not ready. Let's just say the legs and nutrition aren't ready. This was just spur of the moment. Got out of the RV and wanted to ride. All right, I had to take a quick stop there. I had to take off the gloves. They just stunk so bad and they're hot. So definitely want to take those off. Plus it feels a lot cooler. I have some other ones that I'm going to cut the fingers off. They don't have any gel pads or anything, but they're still good enough. Unfortunately, there's no bike shops close to me. Closest one's in Georgia. That's 30 minutes south of me. And it's a bike shop, but it's more of a repair shop. So they don't really have a lot of inventory. And it's mostly mountain bikes here. Whoa. So, cruising along nicely. Get to go in the big ring. See if I can avoid these potholes that are being disguised by the shadows. One of those will be the death of me. And here comes the climb. Come on, change. Well, we'll say I aired down the tires. When I got it, it was the guy loaded them up hard as a rock. So in the RV park we're at, they have little gravel road, and I rode it on there, and I almost ate shit because they were so hard. Okay, Wilson Lick. Apparently this is a little stop. Wilson Lick Ranger Station. Yay, still going up. So we're about 1.3. Yep. Keep going. All right. We are at the top. And I can't wait to see this view. So we are at 4.20 at 41 minutes. So it's 10 minute miles. Holy cow, that's what I run. But well worth it. I had to stop a few times, adjust my seat post height and adjust the angle. So other than that, looks like we are here. Glad that's over. Oh. Holy.
Man. When did you start? What time?
43 minutes ago. It was 4.4 miles. That's horrible, man. All right, we made it to the top. Look at this view. Come up here. People are freaking out because they see me right up here, but it's not bad. And then we have those two up there. Just met them. They're hiking the AT. So the AT comes, the trail comes up there. But you can see, this isn't bad. Legs feel pretty good. Legs feel good. I don't know. Downhill worries me a little bit. But we'll make it. Let's go downhill. Now, I don't know if I should be on the drops or the hoods holding the brakes. Let's see if I go down to the hoods. Okay. I could still get the brakes, but I wish I had a little bit less throw. I wish I could reach them a little more. They're just outside the reach of my pointer finger. I have to use my middle finger. I'm gonna stay on the hoods for now. Get me some gravel bars. Is it sacrilegious to put gravel bars on a cyclocross bike? Or does it even matter anymore? I won't be racing cyclocross. All right, I'm getting the hang of the turns, I think. Definitely much different. I had a Trek stash prior to this, and you know, that wasn't very slack,
But that thing climbed and descended like money. And this thing being, oh, there's the truck. This thing being so far over the front handle of ours, that's crazy. Hey, all right. All right, all right, all right.
All right, according to the Garmin, it is 8.75 miles in exactly 1 hour. So average speed was 8.6, max was 24 miles an hour. Obviously, that's going downhill. So pretty good shakedown ride. I really, really enjoyed it. Obviously, the bike is ready. My legs are not. I was a little worried about I'd be dehydrated, but I drank a shitload of Gatorade before I came on the trail. And then in this water bottle here, I had some amino acids and electrolyte mix just in case cramping set in. So it didn't. I felt really, really good. I sweat all the way up. Obviously didn't sweat on the way down, but everything else was good. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned. I'm going to be doing more videos now that I have a new adventure to tackle. Stick with me. I got some parts ordered for the Crocket. And really debating painting it. Let me know what you think down below. So that's it. From Franklin, North Carolina, Scotty Waddy. Make sure you hit the subscribe and like. We out of here.